at this time, especially because there's such a critical need for a workforce that will be intelligent and educated and a citizenry that will be able to engage in democracy, I think we've got to do something different. I think this is a time to challenge the status quo like no other time. That sense of urgency is there.
Building of a school, the changing of state policies based on what we know now, the changing of federal policy and CRISPR messaging about early childhood, those are all wonderful things. But there's another step to the continuum, and that step is innovation. That step is saying what we've already done is not enough, what we already know is not enough. We need to know more, we need to learn more, we need to do more, and we're not going to get there without taking some risks.
This kind of theory of change idea is to me essential to understanding effects on kids. And it's essential because it allows us to understand in context what we're seeing and what we're not seeing. It's essential because it allows us to take the information we learn and use it to either retool an intervention, to revise a strategy, to identify places that we think we've missed, and then to think about how we would take parts of the intervention to scale.
The most important thing is that we're going to be continuously learning and getting better. And at the end of the day, we're going to hold ourselves responsible for making deep, deep change. That's a long-term worldview. It requires a lot of resources, but its potential is enormous. And if we can get enough funders, policymakers, and practitioners bought in, it really may lead to some of the transformational outcomes that all of us dream of.